Anybody who knows Sanskrit and English both can make out in my being, this whole satsang is going on in Sanskrit, I am translating in English. The structure of the statement I am making, the structure of the statements I am making, the sandhi samasa connections, and the places where I am connecting the statements and ideas, places where I am leaving it without connecting them, assuming you will connect and understand, this whole flow, if you know Sanskrit and English, you can simply make out, I am thinking in Sanskrit and speaking in English. Actually, I am not thinking. It is getting downloaded. That's the truth. It is getting mapped in Sanskrit and getting translated into English. You just see, read the transcript of my satsang or listen intensely the way I structure the statements. How I put the verb, noun, how I connect them. This whole flow, you can simply read and see. See, the language I am talking, the words I am talking, the words I am uttering, maybe English words, but the grammatical structure is Paninis. It is not the English grammar. Understand? Anybody who knows even little Sanskrit and little English can understand this truth I am declaring. Watch any of my satsang, you can see very clearly the Panini Sutra, Panini's grammar based structure, the statements formation using English words is my satsang. Whether I speak in Tamil or English, in Tamil satsang also, complete Panini's grammar, Panini's sutras, that Mahabhashya structured statements formation using the words which is used in Tamil language. Actually, 60% are Sanskrit words, and actually, in those days, there was no separate, like a Sanskrit words and Tamil words. It's one and the same, both from the same root. So, I don't want to get into that fight. Let me be very clear. Listen, whether I speak in English or Tamil, the fundamental statements I form, the way I develop my logic, the way I connect the concepts, everything, if you see, you can very clearly see inside it is going on in Sanskrit and outside it is being spelled out in English. Any Sanskrit scholar, any person who knows Sanskrit and English can simply make out, I am speaking in the structure of Sanskrit grammar. The way I form the structure, the way I connect the logic, and sometimes leave it without connecting, expecting or assuming you will understand it as it is. You will connect it and grasp it. This whole flow is not Ren and Martin's flow. Ren and Martin is the grammar book we read in the schools. It is not the flow of Ren and Martin. It's a flow of Panini. I speak, I use English vocabulary, but the grammar structure, grammar format, grammar foundation of Panini. My statement formations are more closer to Tukrunjikarana than Ren and Martin. Understand? And I tell you, if you are listening to satsang regularly, already your brain has started mastering the foundation of Sanskrit structure, Sanskrit grammar, and statement formation in Sanskrit. See, the way the nouns, verbs, other components of the statements connected, and the concept or the truth or the idea is conveyed, is very profound in Panini. So the structure I am manifesting is from Panini. Panini structure using English words. That is why all my satsangs, digital translation, translating based on computer will be too easy. And the accuracy will be very, very, very high, because what computer does is my brain is doing. See, computer uses the foundation of the Sanskrit grammar and uses the vocabulary from various languages, because the foundation structure of the Sanskrit grammar is the most beautiful, strong, powerful infrastructure. See, think in Sanskrit, you will never fall into depression, because your mind can't be broken. You need to know. Your body is very important for your life. Because only through your body you are enjoying your life. Same way, your verbal structure inside is your mind. If you constantly repeat inside that you are healthy, happy, blissful, in next 3 months you will see you are really, you became that. If you constantly start repeating, I believe I am depressed. If you repeat that for 3 months, you will become that. So consciously, the words you empower and repeat inside you is your mind. That is why I insist on learning a little bit of Sanskrit, because a Sanskrit grammar mind, very difficult to break. Actually, it can't be broken. That's the truth. If it can be broken, you are not thinking in Sanskrit. You may be a scholar in Sanskrit, but thinking in Sanskrit is different. I don't think, there is no thinking in me, but the mapping happens in Sanskrit. You see, pick up my earliest available video. I think earliest available video we have, my satsang is something like 2001 or 2. Pick up that. That's in Tamil, I think. From that video till today's satsang. Analyze everything. Whether I spoke in Tamil or English. Both language. See the way the Sandhi Samasa, verb, noun, organizing. The way I repeat, insist, connect few things again and again, and the way I leave it unconnected or without connecting, without being bothered to connect it, some concepts, ideas, words, everything if you see, absolutely, it flows with Panini. सर्वे सर्वार्थवाचकाः योगिनः पक्षे पतंजलि राइट्स इन व्याकरण महाभाष्य सर्वे सर्वार्थवाचकाः योगिनः पक्षे ऑल वर्ड्स गिव ऑल मीनिंग्स फ्रॉम द पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ एन एनलाइटन्ड बीइंग सो An enlightened being is perspective of understanding of statements or sentence is completely holistic. Understand? Maybe some of my disciples who know Sanskrit and English, you guys can do the analysis of the statement I am making. All the statements I form and present will be Sanskrit grammar based, structure based. That is why if you feed my English satsang and translate it into Portuguese or French, the translation will be very accurate. Then anybody else's Sanskrit, somebody else's English talks, feed them into computer and translate them digitally. The translation's authenticity, and feed my satsangs into computer and translate them digitally. The translation's authenticity, accuracy, mine will be too high. The reason is computers themselves are programmed to follow the structure base of Panini. Because that is seems to be the most perfect, comprehensive, best possible structure for translation into any international, any language in the world. Patena Varana विद्यन्ते वर्णेषु अवयवान च वाक्यात् पदानां अत्यन्तं प्रविवेगो न कश्चन. There are no syllables in words. There are no parts in the syllables. There is no meaning when you break a sentence part by part, because Shabda Brahman is akanda, unbroken. This is from Vyakarana Siddhanta, Vakyabadiyam. The one who is enlightened, one who has realized Sabda Brahman, for him all words mean everything. As he understands all sentences holistically and holistically. H-O-L-I-S-T-I-C-A-L-L-Y and W-H-O-L-L-I-S-T-I-C-A-L-L-Y. Why? English words are not wrong. Renan Martin is wrong. Living in the modern world is not wrong.
being materialistic is wrong.